You know, sometimes numbers don't tell the entire story. Clemson has won 20 straight here in Death Valley. Clemson has never lost to an FCS school in 33 tries, while your Wofford Terriers are 1-22 all time against FBS competition. But ESPN.com gives the Terriers a 0.3% chance of winning this battle here today. So to quote that noted American philosopher Jim Carrey in that American film classic Dumb and Dumber, so you're saying there's a chance.
I told you guys this on Thursday, and I told you again on Friday. Okay? We're taking this field as one group. You guys with me?
Yes, sir.
We don't have to be better individually. And there's some guys in here that are better. You guys got me?
Yes, sir.
But what we got to be today is we got to be better as a team, as a group. And so when you feel that guy next to you, everybody connected right now, there's a lot of strength in that. You guys understand that?
Yes, sir.
You are not out there alone. You're not. Okay, you got your brothers next to you, and you got your coaches on the sideline. All right, and we're all in this thing for one common goal, one common purpose. We didn't come down here just to tee it up, all right, and say, well, I hope it goes well. We came down here to execute and win the game. You guys understand that?
Yes, sir.
That's what we came out to do. So that's how we're going to take the field. What I need from you guys right now is I need you to make a decision that no matter what happens for four quarters, all right, you guys are going to play as hard and as fast as you can. Not because I'm asking you to, but because that's what it's going to take today. You guys understand that?
Yes, sir.
You're going to have to play hard and fast for four quarters. That's what you got to do. Okay? Let's go out there. Let's get after their ass, right, from the start. You guys show South Carolina, all right, what Wofford's football is all about. You understand that?
Yes,
all right, let's go.
Lawrence hands it off again. It's Etienne who's stacked up. Nice defensive surge by Wofford after a gain of about a yard and a half. Back to pass Lawrence. Play action fake. All day to throw over the middle. And that's going to be complete for a touchdown. On first and 10, Tigers from the North 45. They'll hand it to him on the end around. Plenty of room. Down the right sideline. 40. 30. Kevon Cobb makes a touchdown saving tackle. Lawrence hands it off. Bouncing left, making a man miss. 20, 10, cutting inside and stepping into the end zone. Joe takes it, he'll option to the right. He's got a hole, following a blocker across the 20, out across the 25. Good first down, about 16 for Joe Newman. He's going to hand the ball off right up the middle. Etienne spins across midfield, gets into Wofford territory. Again, his handoff up the left side. Nobody is going to touch Travis Etienne.
He and I, contrary to party belief, are not going to have a race later.
Decide this one. Pitch and Lovelace has room down the left sideline. He's going to veer out of bounds after getting the first down. Well, there's Etienne on second and 7. He breaks into the secondary again. 40, 30, 20, 10. Touchdown, Clemson. Allen to the right. And Allen will get it. He's got room up the middle across the 30 before he slammed down. Got broke through for about 7% third down conversions. And another handoff inside. And first down, picking his way nicely and breaking to the left for a good long gainer. Swing pass out to the left. And again, good defense by Wofford on Lynn J. Dixon. Now he'll throw it. Quick hitter and seam. That's going to be complete. And walking into the end zone. Pass looked right, tucks it under, rolls left. And that's intercepted. 20, 15. In the backfield, snap. Handoff. And now, nope. Good ball fake by Lawrence. He'll keep it. Roll to his left and step into the end zone. Morgan's in the backfield. Newman will roll to his left. He's got some room. First down. Newman out across the 30. The 35 steps out of bound in front of the Clemson bench. Lawrence passes left. It's complete. Oh, it's knocked away. Drop. Nice play by Darren Pascoe. I think he got the hand in there on Justin Ross. Rolling out to his right is Lawrence. He'll throw. Good intermediate route. Complete at the 20. Down the sideline. Staying in bounds and diving across the goal line for a touchdown. Today, Newman's back to pass. Long pass, wide open. It's complete. Inside the 25, Allen kind of goes backwards, but still a long, long catch. Pass play, that's going to be about 25 yards. Lovelace in motion, gets the pitch from Newman. He's got room. 15, 10, 5. Touchdown, Terriers! Ryan Lovelace from 20 yards out. Wofford's on the board. 38 to play third quarter. Right side, slashing run right up the middle, cutting back. Knocked down inside the 15, down to the 14. Wrencher is the running back to his left. And Wrencher gets it, pounding it in the middle and across the goal line. Huge surge. On offense for Wofford as Broussard takes a handoff on a sweep. Bounces off a man, breaks a tackle across the 20 to the 21. Good, tough 6 yards for d'Mauriae Broussard on that play. Walker to his left, Newman back to pass. Joe goes long, lost it over the middle. It's complete. VanCleave has daylight. 30, 20, 10. Touchdown, Terriers. 80 yards, Joe Newman to d'Mauriae VanCleave. 20, back at the Clemson 28. Bryce is going to throw again. Steps up in the pocket. Oh, he's got plenty of room to run, and he is going to get close to the first down. I think he's going to be about a yard short. Now he gets back into his crouch in the shotgun and gets the snap. He's back to pass. Dumps it off. It's complete. Parker across the 25. You hear the call from Sweeney. The kick is up. Kind of a line drive, and it's no good. Might have been partially deflected. Snap. Mosley goes left. He'll have to keep it. The ball's knocked out. It's on the ground, and Clemson will recover. Snap. Hold. This one's up high, and this one is good.
What's your overall level of either satisfaction or dissatisfaction with the overall effort start to finish today?
I thought the effort was great. I mean, our guys didn't blink. I mean, they played for four quarters as hard as they could. Some of the execution wasn't exactly what it needed to be. But, you know, that's kind of goes hand in hand with a team like this. But their effort was really good.
In the end game, would the Terriers be better for having played a team like this in a game like this down the road?
I hope so. Yeah, I do. I really hope so. I hope it helps, you know, play better competition. Gets you ready to go. The biggest concern that I have is just the totality of the shots that you take, you know, against guys that are big and physical and fast, you know, and so we got to get healthy, we got to get ready to go, and we got three really physical games coming up. So that's my biggest concern right now, but we'll get back in tomorrow morning and get to work on Mercer.
That's right. You don't want a team like Clemson to beat you twice. You don't want to be so beat up mentally and physically that you can't take care of business down the stretch run. For Wofford, that stretch run has pretty much begun. We'll see you next week from Macon as the Terriers take on Mercer. For Inside Wofford Football, I'm Jim Noble.